Hey explorers, it's Justin again. Welcome back to Urban Geography, where you take on the role of an urban planner designing your very own city. You spent the first day of your job training thinking about your city's location, which is a great start. But this next part of your master plan is going to make or break your dream city. Guess what it is? Here's a hint. You use it every single day. Brushing your teeth, turning on the lights, even right now watching this video. Any ideas? When you use water, electricity, and the internet, you're using infrastructure. Infrastructure is essential to a city's standard of living. What other examples of infrastructure are there, and why is it so important? And how do urban planners choose the best infrastructure for their city? We'll be visiting a few cities around the world to help us answer these questions. All right, explorers, let's get into it. So, what do we mean when we say infrastructure? Infrastructure is all the systems and services that support daily life in a city. Resources like water, electricity, and the internet are all utilities, or essential infrastructure in built structures like homes and offices. Also, cities manage public services that benefit their residents, like public schools, hospitals, parks, affordable housing, and waste management. And transportation infrastructure like roads, bridges, subways, and bike lanes all connect people to these services. Think about a typical day in your life. What infrastructure do you use every day? Infrastructure is like a city's backbone. All of these systems and services keep cities connected and functioning. It can really make or break a city's standard of living. Imagine a city with poor infrastructure. Daily life there is probably frustrating and unsafe. Unrepaired roads might lead to traffic and accidents, and lack of clean water or waste management could spread disease. And if the city has unreliable utilities like electricity and internet, businesses might decide to move their operations elsewhere, hurting a city's economy. Now imagine a city with strong infrastructure. Why might good infrastructure improve this city's standard of living? Strong infrastructure has direct benefits to public health. Utilities like clean water help avoid contamination issues, public services like hospitals extend life expectancies, and public transportation reduces air pollution. Strong infrastructure has social and economic benefits too. Which public services might help with wealth inequality, for example? Affordable housing might help low-income communities afford the high cost of urban living. Plus, access to higher education can help people find higher-paying jobs in the tertiary and quaternary sectors. Good infrastructure can even attract businesses to a city. Why might this be? Reliable roads, ports, airports and internet help people, ideas, and goods move efficiently, which reduces business costs. They also make it easier for residents to access their jobs, either by commuting or logging on at home. So, if your dream city has strong infrastructure, it'll be healthier and wealthier. But infrastructure isn't one size fits all. How do you think urban planners design the best infrastructure for their city? La Paz, Bolivia, and Perth, Australia are two completely different cities with different infrastructure needs. Geography and demographics both have big impacts on infrastructure. La Paz is nestled in a mountain valley, so its terrain limits the city's expansion and creates a high population density. Perth, meanwhile, is on flat, coastal land, making the city's population more spread out and less dense. Perth's flat land also makes it easy for the city to spread outward, which is why its transportation infrastructure includes an extensive highway network that connects people living far away from the city center. On the other hand, La Paz has mountainous terrain and a dense population. If you were an urban planner in La Paz, would you design a highway network there too? Explain why or why not in your notes. La Paz's mountains make road building too difficult to build a highway network like Perth's. Instead, urban planners built Mi Teleférico, a cable car system built for getting up and down La Paz's steep terrain. And La Paz's dense population means a lot of riders looking to avoid packed city traffic. More riders makes public transit systems like the cable car system more affordable and efficient for its riders. A city's dominant economic activities will also influence what infrastructure urban planners prioritize. Perth's coastal location makes it a global shipping hub for Australia's mining industry. Perth's quaternary sector is also developing, with international businesses contributing to strong financial and tech sectors. If you were an urban planner in Perth, what infrastructure would you prioritize to keep this economic activity running? As a trading hub, Perth's port and its surrounding roads need to be well maintained. Plus, a growing quaternary sector needs a fast, reliable internet network. La Paz's economy, meanwhile, is built around its tertiary sector, especially its informal market scene and tourism. If your city was a tourist hotspot, what infrastructure might you prioritize? La Paz's service economy means the city has to be accessible. A reliable airport, pedestrian-friendly streets, and the city's trusty cable car system help visitors explore the city. Something to note, though, is that these two cities are at different levels of economic development. Australia's higher GDP means there are more resources for Perth to invest in infrastructure projects. Bolivia's relatively lower GDP makes funding infrastructure projects harder. Lower-income areas in La Paz, especially informal settlements, have unreliable access to key utilities and public services. That's why urban planners consider these factors when planning infrastructure. With limited budgets, urban planners have to prioritize the infrastructure that's the most important for their residents. All right. Ready to practice some urban planning yourself? Welcome to Amsterdam, the capital of the Netherlands. Let's see what makes this city famous for great infrastructure design. Look at Amsterdam's site factors first. The city is built on soft, unstable land next to a bay. Most of the city is actually below sea level. This means the city is prone to flooding. What infrastructure might you build to manage water levels? Much like New Orleans from Unit 2, Amsterdam controls flooding with a complex canal system. These canals are also a major transportation route and tourist attraction. Speaking of tourism, take a look at Amsterdam's economy. The city is both a popular tourist destination and a major center for European finance and technology. Also, Amsterdam's proximity to the North Sea connects it to major international trade routes. What infrastructure might you focus on to keep Amsterdam's economy running? To keep goods moving, the city invests a lot into maintaining its port, one of the busiest in Europe. And to attract international businesses, Amsterdam invests in high-speed internet, modern office buildings, and hotels. Amsterdam also provides multiple options for visitors. You can get there by high-speed train from major European cities like Paris and London, or take a plane via Amsterdam's Schiphol Airport. But how do visitors get around once they arrive? Amsterdam's population density might give us a clue here. The city's population is pretty dense, partly because the city's surrounded by water and doesn't have much space for huge highways or parking lots. What kind of transportation infrastructure would you focus on with limited space and a dense population? Amsterdam's urban planners prioritize public transit options for its dense population, like the metro, buses, and ferries. The city even has over 300 miles of bike lanes, popular with both visitors and locals. This is why Amsterdam has awesome infrastructure planning. Despite working with limited space, urban planners found a way to design infrastructure that's built for its environment, supportive of Amsterdam's economy, and efficient for its population. Thanks for joining me today, explorers. Today we learned about how infrastructure provides the foundation for a city's success. Urban residents depend on infrastructure like utilities, public services, and transportation every single day. And as we saw in cities like La Paz, Perth, and Amsterdam, factors like a city's site factors, demography, and economy require urban planners to adapt infrastructure decisions to a city's unique needs. So, what infrastructure do you think will be the best fit for the city in your master plan? Well, that's going to depend on the specific needs of your city. As the urban planner, it's up to you to figure out what those needs are in the lesson activity. I can't wait to see what infrastructure decisions you make, explorers. In the next lesson, we'll see how infrastructure shapes the entire structure of a city by studying something called urban models. Until then, keep exploring. See you next time! Hey.